Recursive methods are increasingly important in the modern math classroom. The Prizm is equipped to illuminate recursive functions to students across multiple representations with its recursion feature. After selecting Recursion from the main menu, you'll see a screen with the option to enter up to three recursive equations. By default, each equation is set up to find a sub n plus 1 in terms of a sub n. Suppose you want to work with a recursive function that had an initial value of 1 and increased by 3 with each subsequent term. By selecting n a sub n with f4, we have the option to add 3 to a sub n. Choosing set with F5 allows the user to configure start and end values for n, as well as input the initial value, in this case, 1. Now, to see the numbers generated by this equation, select the table option with F6. You can scroll down to see all of the values that we told the Prizm to solve for on the set screen. There are several options for viewing this data graphically. You have the option to view a connected graph or view the data as a set of unconnected plotted points. In either case, the trace feature will reveal the points from the table. Let's take a look at how a couple of well-known examples of recursion can be set up using recursion on the Prizm. First, the Fibonacci numbers. The first two Fibonacci numbers are 1 and 1. After that, subsequent Fibonacci numbers are found by adding the previous two numbers in the sequence. The Fibonacci numbers can be calculated with the Prizm, but we'll need to change modes to do it. Select type with F3 and choose a sub n plus 2. Now add a sub n plus 1 to a sub n. Finally, define a sub 0 and a sub 1 to both be 1. The table will now reveal the Fibonacci numbers. Of course, students also have the opportunity to view the Fibonacci numbers graphically with Prizm. A calculus application for recursion is Newton's method. Newton's method finds zeros by calculating better and better approximations using the formula a sub n plus 1 equals a sub n minus f of a sub n over f prime of a sub n. Let's find a zero of the function f of x equals x squared minus 2. A sub n plus 1 equals a sub n minus a sub n squared minus 2 all over 2 a sub n. With an initial guess of 1, Newton's method quickly finds the root to 10 decimal places, which you may recognize as the decimal approximation of the square root of 2. As recursive methods continue to become more important in the classroom, the Casio Prizm is there to meet the challenge. The Prizm's recursion feature can be applied to a wide variety of recursive applications, from simple linear relations to Newton's method.